Welcome to a new test and teardown video. I expect this one will be very, very short. And that is because this Hameg oscilloscope here is an HM205-2. And this is very, very similar to the -3 I already reviewed. So depending if you got a -2 or -3, please look at the correct video. But I expect 99% of all the things I will find today on this particular scope will be exactly the same as the -3 version. However, I do see a few differences. So let's just focus on the differences first. Here, we used to have red push buttons for magnifying on the channel. And the AC-DC switches, as you can see, they are here. And on the other one, they are right next to the other one here. So, and that is more or less all the differences I can see on the front panel. And yes, it is updating. Oh, I'm sorry about I'm updating real slow, and I'm with all this light, I am running a very fast shutter time. Why isn't the shutter time changing? So what we can do is we can just go faster, right? And all we have to do is just up the frequencies a little bit. Oh yeah, by the way, this model, there's actually also another difference. Now we're in analog mode. As you can see, the picture is really, really sharp and good and great. And then this model, if you don't know this particular model, you will think, oh yeah, this is just an analog scope. So store is storage. So there is actually a digital storage module in this one, exactly like the -3 model. However, the later model, they wrote it very, very big and loud and clear here on the front. It was an analog digital scope. And on this one, it's kept like a secret. On this, obviously, a little bit previous model. So let's go into the digital. Hello. Why is that looking like absolutely crap? That is weird. Ah, look at that. The hold button was pressed. So that means the digital is of course not going to add data, but it's only going to read the data. So now I go into storage and we are in storage mode, right? See, if I hold the data and go out of analog mode, I can of course remove the input. I can go into storage mode and I can read back whatever was in its memory. So it's not that easy to see the hold. Anyway, that was a little bit stupid. I didn't see the difference. So now when it is running in digital mode, on analog mode, you can't really see the difference. I mean, not in this view. So let's zoom in a little bit more. I don't know if you can see it now. We got a little bit of... This is analog. This is digital. It is not so easy to see. Not with my eyes, but I can see there's a little bit of different refresh rate on the way that it is updating the screen. And you can also see it's a little bit digital. But if I go into hold mode, then it is actually showing, you know, a standstill version. Also, there's a feature here called dot connect. Well, it's actually just a filter on the and the digital to analog converter. So that will smooth down a little bit. See, there's actually a little one little pixel here in the stored picture, and with this filter enabled, you see one dot is almost not visible anymore here. So we could probably remove the hold and see now this single pixel is not there anymore. Probably because I had some noise or whatever I was doing here, right? So that is actually the thing. There's one more little change here. If I go faster and then go into digital mode, you hear this warning about you're now running too fast for digital. See? And this is obviously what's going to happen because of the sampling rate. Then we can do the dot connect. So you'll see there's a filter after each dot. That's pretty cool. Also, I think this model, there is a, let me show you guys this in analog mode. Here is a fun thing. I think someone moved this knob, because this can't be right. I am now in the fastest. Isn't that 1 microsecond per division? This is the fastest, right? But that pulse here is 1 microsecond wide. You don't see the leading edge because there isn't enough delay line in this unit, but it triggers quite all right on the pulse. To prove if there's something weird with the time base, let's try and change the pulse width from 1 microsecond to 2 microseconds. You see what I'm saying? This is 2 microseconds. What if we go to 5? Ooh, that doesn't work. So what is that? Dot one. I have to play with this a little bit, not to bore you with that. But I think there's somebody. Maybe we can just pull this knob and put it back on, or maybe there's a screw so we can put this right. So yeah, that's how I always test if it can do this 1 microsecond pulse, and the repeat is 100 kilohertz, as you can see here. And it's really nice and sharp, and everything is super good with the scope here. So I'm really super happy about all that. Yeah, and everything here works. We need to massage the pots a little bit, then they're gonna be good. As you can see, yeah, now there's a contact. So look at that, huh? Yeah, that is quite typical from old stuff that was stored for a long time, and then all you have to do is just use it a little bit. But I really want to open this and see if it is exactly the same as the other one I already reviewed, and you are more than welcome to look at the two videos and do a little compare. And now we're inside. This is definitely a completely different scope from version 2 to version 3. I mean, both amplifiers there, or input boards here, they're completely different looking, and the main board here is, yeah, it's sort of smell of the same, but it's also a completely different layout. It's very easy to see this capacitor here is not the same place and the same location, and everything is moved around a little bit. So yeah, I did not expect that. I was expecting a 99% equal. Oh yeah, let's look at that. That is the digital storage module. It is located down here. So this is the top side of the unit, but all the time base and triggering and all that kind of stuff is located. You see the custom Hameg time base IC is right there with its crystal and all that goody goody super accurate time base stuff. So that is super super good. The digital or analog and digital sample board is a completely different design on this one. However, I think this connector is the flat cable you could connect to here on the back, because the other model had a connector here so you can connect a printer. And that is also shown in my other video, by the way. Oh, maybe need to tighten the screws a little bit here. Also, I think I need to clean up a little bit down here, and that resistor is probably a little bit rusty. Look at all the dust here collected, a little bit of moisture and stuff. So that is a very good idea to clean this up, and it's clearly that the resistor that was out here where dust is landing, that's also more corroded. The other one is nice and shiny. So you see what dust can do to your electronics. Yeah, we can't really see the sample board that well because it's hidden down here in the other version. The digital board was located here, so it was super easy to see. But there isn't really any room for that right here in this model, and they later changed that. So there isn't really a lot to show and tell. I mean, it looks like 90% of the stuff is more or less the same. The RAM, the all that kind of stuff is looking like it's more or less the same. But what I can see is the connectors, they're not located at the same edges on the PCB, so it's definitely not the same PCB. So yeah, there is a lot of differences on the scopes here, but it's exactly the same specifications. And this scope here is also doing 20 megahertz, just perfectly fine in analog mode. And it's handling 100 kilohertz fine in digital mode. So you see a little bit of ugly stuff here in the high voltage section. You can see a little bit of brown dust, and I don't like that. So I always clean up stuff like that. Can't be good. So yes, definitely time to clean up a little bit more, and then I will assemble this nice scope. I hope you had a little bit of fun, and I hope to see you again tomorrow. Now I'll play with the time base switch here, and I think I recall this is the way. Yeah, this is the entry. So this one I have to remove first, and then I can pull this off, and then I can, I think that is the way to calibrate. I think it was not assembled correctly here. So with the first button or knob removed. This little piece taken out. See, it's easy to fix. And yes, indeed, the knob here was too loose, so it was moved. Ha ha! That makes sense. It's important the time base is correct, you know. And as always, when you poke around in old scopes, always look at the label on the CRT. Most likely it will reveal the age of this unit. 1988.